Hey guys, Paul with guns.com here, and I have a rifle that is new to 2022. As you can tell, it's an AR pattern. This is from Smith & Wesson. This is their Volunteer Pro line. There's a couple different variations for the Volunteer Pro. We have already cleared this one, so I'm gonna send the bolt home. Overall, very smooth, the bolt. Sometimes you'll get them to be gritty, stuff like that. I haven't had any issues like that with this particular AR. Unique feature on it, right out the gate, actually kind of had me checking specs really quick, and that is a 14.5-inch barrel. And if you know about ARs and rifles in general, you need to have a 16-inch barrel for it to not be an NFA item. The way they got around that is this muzzle brake, which is pretty aggressive, much better than that A2 birdcage that you're going to see on a lot of ARs. It works, it's a bit loud, but it definitely helps the gun shoot nice and flat. That is pinned and welded. If you're good with a muzzle brake that does its job just fine and you're not trying to put a can on it or something, that's fine. But pinned and welded, that's not coming off. And that's how they got it to be the length that it is. Overall, when I tape it in, you're looking at 32 inches with the stock collapsed, just over 35 inches when you pull it all the way out and extend it. Stock is another interesting feature that you don't see on a lot of ARs, especially kind of out-the-box ARs. And it's going to have this kind of increased cheek weld area up front. And that is a B5 stock. It's also got a very aggressive pistol grip texturing here. It's kind of got stippling on the two sides and then also up front. And then it's clean on the back, which is actually nice if you're shooting this barehanded. It's enough where you really can lock your hand in. I often prefer the traditional AR pistol grip, which has a little bit of a hump here for your finger because you can lock your hand in. This works pretty well. And it's not abrasive when shooting. We're at just over about 100 rounds on this. We're going to take it out, keep doing some more testing, put it through some rapid fire. But it's accurate, it's flat shooting. Like I said, it's going to be a little bit loud with that muzzle brake, louder than your regular birdcage, but totally manageable, really. Up top, you're looking at pick rail all the way from the receiver down to the end of the handguard, and then you have M-lock on the sides. Now, something that I often complain about for M-lock is it just makes it a little bit more complicated for mounting. And props to Smith & Wesson, because they already thought about that. First of all, it comes with MagPul grip panels that you can just pop right into the M-lock. That's really nice. I actually am probably going to buy some of this for some of my own ARs. It's grippy. You can place it strategically however you prefer to hold the gun. Helps you index nice and quickly. Feels really robust. It's just a really nice added feature. And the other thing that they did, which I appreciate if you wanted to add like a light and you have a pick rail light already, they include a little piece of pick rail that's going to plug right into your M-lock. And it's going to come with a 30-round MagPul magazine. So out of the box, you've got a pretty nice AR that's nice and short, compact, comes in just under 7 pounds, but it feels more wieldy than a lot of other ones. And I think a big part of that is it is hacked off that chunk of barrel, 1.5 inches up here. Gives you a little bit more of a balance to the rear of the firearm. Another thing that is interesting and I found to really enjoy is it does not have a mil-spec trigger. It has a flat face trigger up here. The reset on this is positive and short. The pull is pretty crisp and clean. It is something that, I mean, if you're used to mil-spec triggers, I'm not really a trigger snob, but you'll kind of feel the clunkiness of them. And this one has a nice little break. Charging handle. Also ambidextrous. Some people love it, some people hate it. There is not an ambidextrous safety on this one. I actually prefer that, because if you have a high pistol grip and you're holding on like this and you have a safety lever right here and you're a righty and you're trying to swap that, you actually have to break your grip a little bit. So I understand that that's a trend that you're seeing. I actually think it's a solid call if this is supposed to be kind of a standard out-of-the-box duty gun, just doing the left side safety lever. I actually appreciate that. If you look on this side, pretty standard bolt release. Another feature that shows that Smith & Wesson was paying attention is this is optics ready, but they included front and rear collapsing sights, which are actually metal. I know a lot of us are used to the MagPul, the polymer ones. I like them. These work just as well. Positive, they lock up nicely. There's a little button right here that you can push that's gonna release it. It's gonna have that standard adjustable front post, so you can just get a sight tool or use like the tip of a bullet and you can just rotate that up or down for elevation. And then it's adjustable back here for windage. I really like shooting irons. It's one of the reasons I have this optic on it. We were doing some shooting with it just the other day actually, and I had a 7-power LVPO on it. Super, you know, basic kind of standard classic that you're seeing now as like a military go-to is just a variable optic that's not, you're not pushing out 20 magnification, but plenty that you can zoom in and out and still function it pretty close to a red dot. This one is actually my favorite though. Just a prism optic. This is 3 power, so it's not exactly like your precision shooting optic, but it's combat effective optic, and it allows me to easily pop it off because I have a detachable mount here, and then I can go to my irons. The other thing that's nice about it is not only is the balance pretty decent, but this cheek weld that I get back here, we were shooting it off of a rest, and we were shooting it standing. I have a beard, and sometimes when I use the more traditional, you know, car style stock, the M4 style stock that a lot of us are used to, the one you see in a lot of military M4s, it has a tendency to grab my beard hair and rip it out, which is not the most pleasant thing. This one allowed me to get a really positive cheek weld. So you got a generous amount of space here to get a good cheek weld on the stock. That gives me the ability, whether it was with a variable power optic or this 3-power prism, that I can get into the eye box here consistently, not really fishing around trying to find out exactly where I need to be. And then you're locked in nice and positive because you have this. So if you're a person who's looking to do a little bit more precision shooting, or if you know you're not a fan of that really kind of minimalistic stock, it's a nice addition with the B5 stock. Yeah, so like I said, we're going to be putting a lot more rounds through this in the next couple of weeks. So far, my impressions, flat shooter, trigger's really nice. Definitely better than most of the mil-spec triggers you're going to get. It's not a Geissele, right? It's not a super high custom trigger, but for a duty trigger, it's really nice. We've put everything from Wolf steel case, some lower powered reload ammo, and then Winchester 855, you know, the green tip. So far, reliability has been great. We went through about 6-7 30 round mags. Accuracy has been pretty solid. Again, we weren't really out yet pushing how far we could shoot with this, but shooting into the heart of a card was not very hard at 50 yards with just some real quick adjustments. So from the perspective of, is the AR an accurate rifle? Yeah, so it already is a very accurate platform, and this one maintains that reputation. Certainly so far, a reliable, accurate, comfortable gun to shoot. This Volunteer Pro line has been pretty solid so far. Like I said, we'll get out and we'll put a lot more ammo through it. Probably bust out some targets and see if we can get some accuracy testing in as well for you. Well, anyways, guys, that is my review so far through the first 100 or so rounds that we've been pushing through this Volunteer Pro from Smith & Wesson. Again, new for 2022. You can find this on the guns.com website. There's other versions of it as well if you're looking for something that's a little bit more competition oriented instead of duty oriented. We got those as well. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, drop us a comment down below. We like to take that feedback, try and get it into our next video to keep improving for you guys. Other than that, like, share, subscribe, and I'll see you next time.